Live from the studios of Penn Trafford High School. This is Wake Up Warriors with Rachel Gross and Sarah Simpson.
We'll see how well some couples know each other and reflect upon the band concert.
This is Wake Up Warriors.
Good morning, Penn Trafford, and welcome to Wake Up Warriors. Today is Wednesday, February 14th. Happy Valentine's Day. I'm Rachel.
And I'm Sarah.
It is once again Valentine's Day. To lighten up the mood and have some fun, we sent Zach Conley to catch up with some couples and see how well they know each other.
I went around Penn Trafford High School and got to see how well these couples know each other.
Can we reveal?
Yeah,
how? Sweethearts.
No.
No?
No. Spider-Man.
I don't know. You don't really like them, so.
I said she didn't have any. What is it?
I don't know. All movies? Duh.
No,
I like all things. Let's just be clear. Did you wear the same thing as her?
Is this your favorite?
No, I've never seen it. Have you seen this?
I think it's pretty good.
You rather stay in. I don't think I spoke that right.
Yeah. No. Jeez, bro. Terrible.
This is Zach Conley reporting for PTTV. Have a happy Valentine's Day.
Cat projects to sign up for this week are Penn Trafford Spring Food Drive from now until Friday, March 16th. All CAT members, please bring in at least 5 non-expired food items. Students with detentions, you can eliminate 1 detention with a donation of 5 non-expired food items and 15 minutes of volunteer service to help with the food drive. PT Volleyball Tournament, Saturday at 10 to 4 o'clock. Work the concession stand during the tournament. All day or in shifts, 10 to 1 or 1 to 4.
If you are not a current CWCTC student and you would like to apply for next year, you need to pick up an application in the counseling office. All applications are due by Friday, February 23rd.
Study hall changes for today, tomorrow, next Wednesday, and next Thursday are as follows. Mr. Carlisle's second period LGI study hall, Mrs. Meyer's third period LGI study hall, Mrs. Henney's fourth period LGI study hall, Mr. Rieger's sixth period LGI study hall, and Mrs. Korda's 8th period LGI study hall need to report to the Audion. Mrs. Rudinsky's 5th period LGI study hall needs to report to the auditorium.
Monday is the 50th anniversary of the Mr. Rogers Show. You may be a fan or you may only know of him from a trip to Idlewild. On Monday, wear a cardigan and Converse or Keds style shoes as he did every day on his show. 6th period, all students wearing a Mr. Rogers outfit will be photographed in a group photo. We plan to send this photo to WQED-TV.
There are Valentine's Day themed activities planned in the Media Center all day today. Here's Rachel Patterson with information on what is going on and how to sign up.
Hi, my name is Rachel Patterson, and the Media Center will be hosting a Valentine's Day study hall on Valentine's Day, and you can come down to do Valentine's Day themed activities such as a craft and a Mad Libs. Signups are in your email right now, and you can come down to your study hall.
Come see the vintage rom-com Roman Holiday this Friday in the auditorium at 7 for a free movie and free popcorn.
In Mr. Rieger's class, students learned about balanced and unbalanced forces, and to better understand this concept, they hit bowling balls with mallets. They either hit the bowling ball once to only accelerate it, change the direction of their bowling ball, or they hit it multiple times with consistent force to keep the bowling ball at a constant speed.
Are you a student interested in science? Do you like doing fun science experiments? Enter a project in the high school and middle school science fair. The two first place prizes are $50 Amazon gift cards, and the two second place prizes are $25 Amazon gift cards. Ask your science teacher for a sign-up paper and show how much you have learned. Sign-ups are now through March 9th.
Congratulations to Mahogany Martin and Olivia Carrera for winning the Slippery Rock Juried Instagram Art Competition that took place over the month of January. Shayna Rudebeck was also awarded an honorable mention. The competition had a total of 160 drawings submitted by 66 students from 19 different high schools. There were a total of 20 winners and 17 honorable mentions. If you would like to see the submitted works, visit hashtag SRUDraw2 on your Instagram account.
Looks like we are headed for a bit of a warm-up today. Let's take it to Zach Conley to see just how much Penn Trafford is going to heat up for us on this Valentine's Day.
It is currently 46 degrees outside with a slight chance of rain in the morning, 70% chance of rain later on. The high will go up to 49 and the low will go down to 42 later on the day. Let's go back to the desk.
This Saturday is a Chick-fil-A Spirit Day for the PT Drama Guild. Just mention Penn Trafford High School Musical when purchasing your meal and everyone wins. Thanks for your support.
The 36 students that make up the high school jazz band performed yesterday in the cafeteria for their families to celebrate Mardi Gras, a yearly celebration that occurs on the Tuesday before Ash Wednesday. They performed songs like The Mud Bug Strut and The Saints Go Marching In. After their performance, everyone was able to enjoy the king cake generously donated to the jazz band by Giant Eagle.
100 Chick-fil-A gift cards have been given away so far this week in the Media Center. Come play for a chance to win Chick-fil-A. Sign up on the Carnival Gaming Google form for admission. You have until Friday to win and support the Media Center's Senior Citizen Prom.
Any senior who would like to have their art displayed at the Senior Showcase on Wednesday, March 7th, should see Mrs. Crystalite, Mr. Griffith, or Mrs. Haberger about their submissions. All art must be turned into one of the art teachers by Friday, March 2nd.
Senior Travis Barkefeld is looking for assistance with his senior project, PT Live. PT Live aims to be a student-run variety show in the same vein as SNL. The show will feature sketch comedy, musical performances, and talent acts. Travis is looking for actors, stage crew, musicians, and anyone who has an interesting talent they would like to showcase for the show. A sign-up form for anyone interested is available in the Media Center. If needed, please ask Mrs. Kelly Garris or Mrs. Johnson for assistance.
Let's go to Rory Bulwer with your daily sports report.
Come see your undefeated boys and section runner-up girls in the last home meet for the season for the Water Warriors tomorrow night. It is against section rival Norwin. We will celebrate senior night during and after the meet and hope you will join us in honoring this outstanding group of seniors. The wrestling team has a match against Kiski tonight at 7. And we have an update on last week's story about student athletes committing to college. With more on what we left out, here's Josh Beers.
Cam is just a natural. I mean, some people go to games to watch the skill of the players. Some people go to games for the thrill of competition and the excitement. I go to games to watch Cam mop the floor. Without a doubt, his ability to leap out of the stands, grab that mop, and find the exact areas that need to be dealt with. Nobody has an eye for this like Cam.
His first step mop quickness is unbelievable. His eyes are like an eagle. He spots a perspiration on the floor from the end of the court, and he gets there in under 4 seconds. His reaction time is ridiculous. The ref blows the whistle, he's on the floor before the whistle is done being blown. That's how quick he is.
Cameron's mopping is exemplary.
He's stupendous.
He's really good.
First of all, I want to thank God, thank my coaches, thank my teammates out there, all the other coaches that offered me, but for the next 4 years, I'll be taking my talents to West Virginia.
Watching Wake Up Warriors, please stand for the Pledge of the Flag. I'm Rachel.
And I'm Sarah.
Have a happy Valentine's Day, Penn Trafford.